Everybody, happy to meet you all again in my Android framework component tutorials part 9. Dimple here, welcoming you all back to my tutorial on Android framework component. By now we have seen different components of Android framework. In this tutorial we will see what is Android window manager framework. Window manager is responsible for organizing the screen of your application. The interface that your applications use to talk to the window manager is context.getSystemService, and the context is nothing but window service. Window manager organizes your screen and processes, and it also decides what should go where and how they should be layered. Which window should be on the top, which window should go where. So Android Window Manager is a system service which is responsible for managing the Z-ordered list of windows. It will decide which window should be visible or how they should be laid out on the screen. Among other things, it also automatically performs window transitions and animations. So these transitions and animations which appear when opening or closing an application or rotating the screen. So window manager is smart enough to display the type of the view that is required when the device rotates. So it can be the landscape or portrait. All this is automatically decided by window manager. So an activity can have one or more windows. So one or more windows example is dialogue. See, consider an example here. This is an activity and it is having one dialogue. So one activity can have one or more dialogue. So each dialogue here is considered as a window. A window is called a session. So in technical terms, a window is nothing but a session. And a window can have one or more surfaces. So what is this surface? See, for example, consider an activity here. It has two text views and one surface views. So this surface view is nothing but it is an example for a surface. What is the difference between this surface view and a default view? A default view will be handled through your main UI thread, but the surface view has the capability of running in the background, and they can be handled by other threads. So these surface views are faster when compared to your normal default views. So surface views, most of the times it is used in case when you're using some animations in your window. So a window can have one or more surface views also. Now, what is surface manager? Window manager will ask the surface manager to create layout surfaces on behalf of the client application. So the surface manager has the responsibility of dispatching the input events to the clients. It also performs transitions, animations, etc. So window manager will create a surface for your application, and that applications will draw directly into those surfaces without going through the window manager. So once window manager will create the surface for your application will not come again to your window manager. All your application full will interact with only your surface manager. Now, surface manager will create or allocate surfaces, which is nothing but surface manager has the responsibility for creating the memory, front end, back end buffers for your applications to draw its layout. In other words, surface manager will allocate the resources for your window. Now we'll see what is default window versus what is floating window. We all know that each activity has a window that is used to display its contents to the screen. So when you call this function setContentView on an activity, it attaches that default view to the activity. I'll show you all with an example here. So in this application, in main function inside onCreate, setContentView function is called. So once this function is called, the entire window is loaded. which is default. So this is the default window which is loaded, which is nothing, it's just telling hello world a sample program. So this window is loaded. So when this window is being visible, the other windows will be hidden by your activity manager. So this is an example for default window. So the default window will fill the entire screen. As we saw previously, it will fill the entire screen so that your activity window will hide other activities. The window manager will display whichever window is on the top. So normally you don't need to worry about all these windows. You just create an activity and Android will do the rest for you in case of default windows. But what is this floating windows? You need to interact with the window manager if you want to do something unusual like creating floating windows that don't fill the screen. So if you're creating default window, you need not interact with the window manager. But if you're interested in creating the floating windows, you have to interact with window manager. What is floating window? See, I'm showing an example here. This entire thing is my activity. You can see there are many windows and each window is of different size. So these windows are called as floating windows. See, this is 1, 2, 3. There are many floating windows. Each one have their own size and each one is present at a particular location. You can see many windows at once in one activity. So if you want to create a floating window that is visible in front of other apps, you can't use an activity because your activity will stop when other app comes to foreground and its window will be hidden or destroyed. So if you want to create floating windows, you have to do it programmatically. So here is a small code snippet which will show how to create a floating window. So I'm using window manager class and I'm using layout parameters. I'm creating an object P. Okay. So in this, I'm using wrap content. Why I use this is that to shrink the window, to wrap content rather than filling the entire screen. So we all saw previously floating windows will not fill the entire screen. So to shrink that window, to wrap the content, we use this wrap content. Then we use type system alert to display on top of other applications. So when I'm displaying one window, the other window should not be hidden. For that case, I'm using type system alert to display on top of other applications. Then I'm using this flag not focusable, which will not let it to grab the input focus. It will not grab the input focus. Then I'm using this translucent, which will make the underlying application window visible through transparent parts. So that was the layout of the window, floating window. Now the position of where this window should be placed. So this gravity will decide the position of the window within your screen. So here I'm defining my window in the top right of my screen and with x-axis 0 value and y-axis having a value of 100. So this was a small example of how to create a floating window. To summarize, an application will have an activity and each activity can have many windows and these windows are handled by window manager. Window manager in turn will call the surface manager. Surface manager has the responsibility for allocating the resources. So this was the entire chain of how your activity works. Okay, so this was a short description about window manager framework. Let's meet in the next tutorial with some other interesting framework components. Thanks for watching. Bye.